prior to starting any grinding project, it's always good to know the hardness of your concrete slab. Now, hardness is defined in two ways. You have your compressive strength, and that means the amount of downward pressure it would take to, say, crack this slab. But you also have what's called the abrasion strength. And the abrasion strength is very critical in grinding concrete and selecting your tooling. Concrete that will not easily abrade is known to be hard, and concrete that scratches easily is known to be soft. Using the Mohs hardness scratch tester will help you determine that. If you test the slab and your results are that it is hard, then you will need a soft bond tool. The metal in a soft bond tool will wear away quickly and create its own cutting abrasive. This keeps the diamond exposed and cutting. A floor that tests as soft will require a hard bond tool. A soft floor creates a lot of abrasive dust and requires a hard metal bond tool to prevent premature wear. Using a soft bond tool on a soft floor will wear out your tools quickly, and using a hard bond tool on a hard floor will not keep the diamonds exposed and cutting. The picks range in hardness from 9 all the way down to 2. Use the picks, and when they stop leaving a scratch, you have reached the hardness of that floor. In order to get an accurate test result, you do not want to apply too much pressure with downward force by your hand. So what I like to do is I like to put my palm on the surface of the floor and then gently, and letting the pick do the work, scratch the floor. And as you can see and hear, it has left a scratch. That tells us that our floor is softer than a 9. So I've jumped down to a 7 and I'll try the test again. As you can see, you can hear and see the scratch. So we just flip the pick over and we go with a 6. I'm still getting scratches and I can hear the actual pick cutting into the floor. So we'll jump down to a 5. As you can see, you cannot hear or see the pick leaving a scratch. This tells us that our floor is a 5 in hardness. Based on that number, we can now determine the type of diamond, the bond of the diamond that we need to use in order to effectively cut this floor. Your kit comes with a sharpening stone. In order to get accurate results, it is important to keep the tips sharp at all times. Simply grab your tip, run it across the stone, and this will keep your tip sharp and accurate for the next test.